body comes out before the curtain, it is to bring you the sad news that the leading man has had his eye. The leading lady has broken her leg, or her leg is broken by her understudy. No such thing. I am here for another reason. I want to clear the air about something I think you ought to know. You see, I am English. Now, when the management first told us that we were going to be touring the boys, we members got together and swore that each night one of us would come out and say hello to you and to tell you how much we are enjoying touring through the provinces and say how glad we are to be putting on our little pastiche. Pastiche. Now, that is a 10-pound word used in English to describe this sort of show. Personally, I prefer your American term school, because that is what the show really is. It is a school of the English musical comedies of the 1920s. You know, I bet you didn't realize in England we did have 1920s. Ours may not look in roaring 20s like yours, but you must remember, in England, nothing roars. How is my best we refer to as the tittering 20s? We did not have prohibition or speakeasies. But we wore the same ridiculous clothes, danced the same Charleston, and saw the same kinds of musical shows. Well, I hope you enjoy our show.
Thank you.
nothing for a man at least. Paris.
just tell me one thing.
What is it, madame?
Our little Japanese, that the girl is sweet and charming as you, has to pretend to have a, boyfriend, and write yourself love letters.
It's because of my father, madame.
Your father?
Yes. You see, when he dies, I shall be really extremely wealthy. And he thinks that any man who makes advances with me is only after my fortune.
So he forbids you to have a boyfriend?
Well, practically.
So you invent him?
I'm afraid so.
Poor little rich girl. Well, I do let a letter today. From your father. He's coming here this morning.
Daddy, come here?
Yes, he has been to Toulon on business. And when he gets here, I will have a little word.
He won't listen.
Ah, well, we will see. Now dry your eyes and go to class.
Oh, excuse me, madame. Je n'avais pas un petit déjeuner cet ici.
That's right, madame, I'm just about to go. Soyez gay, ma petite, and trust in me. La 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 la.
What was she saying to you, Polly? No. Oh, nothing. My father's coming here today.
Your father? What just happened?
Is he handsome as well as being rich? You wait and see.
Oh, do wait for me, Polly. Oh, but I left my driver back here somewhere.
Oh, where on earth can it be?
Oh, hey.
Well, okay. But don't forget, I'm your dentist partner tonight.
Well, perhaps. I'm not promising anything.
You don't have to. I'm telling you. Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Wish I could see more from them, sir. Take it up with business, you know.
Yes, I understand. But I am sure you would not put these in front of your daughter's happiness.
Polly's happiness? But she's perfectly happy, isn't she? She never complains of her mother's.
Oh, no, I am sure she does not. But there are certain things, monsieur, which a young girl cannot discuss by phone.
Such as what?
Monsieur.
Am I to take it, madame, that you're referring to love? I sincerely hope that nothing of that sort is allowed to occur in your school.
Well, I do not encourage these old dependencies. But well, les gens si, c'est all, les gens si. N'est-ce pas?
I don't follow you, madame.
Surely you've not forgotten all your friends, Monsieur Brown. Or should I call you mon petit, père-ci?
What? Good heavens, it can't be.
Mais oui, mon cher Yves. Do you not remember your little Kiki?
Kiki? No, this is impossible. Most awful.
But this is no way to greet an old friend. After all we have been to each other, have you forgotten? Honestly, tonight at my kiss when you...
Madame, I have completely forgotten.
But surely not. I wore a red dress, and you a uniform. I told you my Saint-Tommy, and we drank champagne, and then we danced, and she offered to play a waltz, which was all the rage in Paris. Let me see. How did you go? I still recall.
Bye. Oh.
I know him. That's Father Coughlin. Hold on. Yes, yes. Are you coming too, Polly?
And I'm expecting Daddy any moment. And aren't you expecting him? Him?
Oh, yes, it does.
Let's leave her, girl. She wants to be alone.
Bye.
beside the box then. Goodbye, Judith.
Goodbye.
Thank you.
much prettier.
I'm not so sure about that, Rupert. In any case, I think we should fall down in the first place.
Nonsense, Hilda. You never ever change from routine to us old people. I'm now 20 years younger.
And behaving accordingly, I know. Really, you could have come.
Oh, come now, Hilda. After all, Tommy isn't dead.
Well, he might as well be. Sometimes, when I think of the disgrace, I would rather he were.
Oh, come now, Hilda. The boy has done nothing wrong.
Nothing wrong. Leaving Oxford in the middle of the Hillary Fair, ruining a perfectly brilliant career. Why? He would even be considered for the constituency now!
Well, never mind, dear. Perhaps he's found another career.
But he has a very loving Hubert, not a penny to his name. Oh, dear, with the palpitations every time I think of it. I shall have to go and sit in a shelter.
Very well, my dear.
Hubert!
Yes, my dear!
Thank you.
gosh, you know, I don't see why she should care what you're doing on your afternoon off.
Why did you not take the afternoon off to be a puppet to that lady, Miss Yu?
Oh, Monty, what's that,
Uncle Hence? Didn't know who he is. He's just a
messenger
going to get
along. Well, if I knew, it wouldn't be nice.
But what would Madame have already seen? She knew this wonderful young lady.
Oh, yeah, yeah, Dad. I'll talk to her then.
Shall I tell him?
Now, wait a minute. Dear Uncle Hence, don't betray me. I know that he is just a messenger boy, but he is doing it because he's poor. And I'm sure that in reality, he is as well born as I am.
Well, perhaps, but he has no right to make it back to a lady like yourself in his present condition.
But he thinks I'm just a secretary.
You thought he
said? Yes, I did.
Hello, can't you
see? Please, Hortense, don't put it on 21. I am so happy to have an admirer who isn't just interested in my work. Surely you must know how I feel.
Well, but what if Madame Brunet was to find out?
She doesn't. That is unlike you, Keller.
All right, you see, I gave you my promise. After all, it is carnival time.
Thank you, Martin. I shall forget.
Go here, my dear lady.
Oh, dear, I don't want to see them just yet. They do chat it, though. Let's go, Tony.
All right, Polly, it's him on here to the moment all.
Thank you, Martin. And remember, you promised.
Now come along, we're going to have our bath.
I'm going to have
haven't brought the baby costume.
Stand up, do you?
You don't mean I should be without her.
No, no. But I know I can borrow one for you. So you wait there, I'll be back. Don't I saw.
But Kiki.
Au revoir, ma petite poisson. Kiki.
I say. Come, I say, old chap.
Were you addressing me?
Well, I wasn't addressing a tree. Actually, old boy. I was wondering if you could help me. You seem to know your way around here, old but jolliest of girls. I'm a stranger here, you see. And what's more, I've got the wife in tow. She's not a hot sort, really, but she doesn't understand me.
I'm afraid I owe this is due for your domestic affair.
I don't want any assistance in my domestic affairs. It's the poor mouth I'm talking about. Now, don't be so standoffish. English and court must stick together, you know?
Yes, of course.
Now, this little lady you were dallying with just now, she seems a sporty little filly.
A sporty little filly? Really, sir, I must ask you to moderate your language. This lady is a highly esteemed member of the community.
Ah, I'm sure she is. The enemy seems somewhat better in France.
She is a head mistress.
Oh. Ah, here she comes, where Ruth Bell introduces.
Ruth Bessie, the lady's mother.
Oh, I'm sorry, madam, I changed my mind. I'm going straight back to the hotel.
But why, Bessie? I thought you such a lovely costume. You mustn't disappoint me now.
Come on, old chap, do what she says.
I've had enough of this. I'm leaving at once, sir.
But why, Bessie? What have I done?
I say, old chap, you're upsetting her, and there's no way to beat that. And mistress!
Will you please go away?
Bessie, why do you not introduce me to your friend? Bessie, we'd like to go swimming instead, eh?
By Jove, like a shot!
Nicky, this gentleman is a complete stranger to me. I've never been either before in my life.
But this is France, my good man. We can afford to... Yes, Francais, Quebec, May, Formalité, n'est-ce pas?
Mais oui, monsieur. Vous avez raison.
I don't know what that means, but it sounds absolutely delicious.
Your
botheration!
Your
mother,
come here,
I was just showing this lady gentleman the way to the end.
You're a British!
Let's go with the old
man. Really, what's an embarrassing situation?
I think you are a little jealous, you know.
Not at all. It's just I like to see people behave decently, that's all.
Just as we're beginning to enjoy ourselves.
I must have been out of my mind.
You know, you want to take your lay down like it. Spoil all the fun.
Kiki, it's high time you realize things are very different from what they were.
Oh, say, Bessie.
Yes, most definitely.
Bessie, Bessie, please stop, Bessie. Why must we always be so sad and gloomy? Why can't you be a little nicer? Thank you.
infect.
You'll still be infected. You sure there wasn't anyone else?
Oh, what if there was? I can go in and do who I choose.
I wish you'd choose me.
I don't want to choose anyone in particular.
Why not?
Well, because I won't have a good time. I'm quite young. After all, I'm only 17.
Well, I can show you a good time. It isn't as if I hadn't plenty of cash.
Money isn't everything.
When are you going to come and see my yacht again? You liked that, didn't you?
Oh, yes. It's a very sneaky yacht. Oh, hello, Marcel.
Ah, Marcel, maybe. You look ravishing. Do not forget. You promised to dance the tango with me tonight.
Oh, of course not.
Maybe.
Oh, Pierre.
Marcel, maybe. You're looking something. Tonight, you have long to sit, yes?
Hardly wait.
Hey, Maisie.
Alphonse!
I do want to dance with you, you both.
And so you shall.
Maisie, listen to me.
Listen to all of us.
I call me happy with you.
want me to?
We're lost.
What's the matter?
I have to call the party with me. I will speak to you tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Polly was out of work. Polly, come.
How is Polly?
Broken hearted, poor pity. She refuses to come to the ball, even though I did my best to persuade her.
Does she want to see me?
Oh, no. But it's a pity she's not enjoying herself in our happy company.
Yes, it was pretty, wasn't it?
But of course, she has no one to dance with. Well then, she might as well stay at home.
I don't suppose. But she probably doesn't want to speak to me now. She probably thinks I'm just a common philanderer. And let me be persuaded to come to the ball. I never could prove that I really do not like.
Well, I do not know if that would be the right thing to do.
But yes.
But I think she's spiteful. She loves you.
Do you honestly?
Don't you promise not to run
away? Oh, I do. And thank you, Orton. I'm going to change into my costume. I was just going to return it to Gaston, but thank goodness I ran into you.
Not thanking anyone of you. She may not have to.
Company me.
Garçon, Garçon, bring this lady a glass of port.
Oui, monsieur, oui, monsieur.
Since he's come to the ball after all, what did I have to say to
him? Let me talk to him, won't you? I know how she is feeling.
Hubert, I think that's the girl we saw with Toby this afternoon.
Are you sure?
Positive. Perhaps if you talk with her, she might be able to tell us his whereabouts.
Yes, I will work with her in a minute.
No, we'll both have a word with her later.
Polly, you darling.
Do I, madame?
But of course. You know you're too wise to come to the door. When one is feeling sad, the only thing to do is try and forget.
I shall never forget.
Grouse, mon grouse. In the meantime, why not enjoy yourself? Look, here are all your friends around you, so do not be downcast.
Hello, Polly. Hello, Polly. We're so glad you come. We all missed you like that. Didn't we, Chester?
Oh, yeah.
Thank you, Polly. It's so nice to know I have some real friends.
Attention, attention, mesdames et messieurs. Asseyez-vous, s'il vous plaît. We now present the race of the continent. Pepe and Lolita, who are going to dance the carnival tango.
Pepe!
I suppose so.
young man?
This, sir, is my son, the Honorable Terry Brocket.
The Honorable Terry Brocket? Hell!
Yes, sir. I'm afraid I'm not Mrs. Wallace. Can you forgive me?
Yes, of course. And who may I ask is this young woman?
This madam is my daughter, and I am Percival Brown.
Percival Brown, Lilina?
Yes, Terry, I'm afraid I deceived you, too. I'm not a secretary after all. Can you forgive me?
Of course, my darling.
It seems as though this is the air.
Molly, I too have some news.
Do you, Daddy, have some really?
May I tell her, Kiki?
But of course, she should be there first to know.
Very well then, Molly. Madame Duvernay has just consented to become my wife.
Maisie, it's midnight. Have you thought it over?
Et toi?